हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज ग्रेड 10 फिजिक्स क्लास चैप्टर 12 इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। इन लास्ट वीडियो क्लास वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल एंड पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस, इजंट इट? यस। स्टिल नाउ नो दिस पॉइंट, स्टिल नाउ आई डिडंट स्टार्ट एग्जैक्टली व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, इजंट इट? बिकॉज दिस ऑल आर बेसिक टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। दैट इज द रीजन व्हाई टिल नाउ आई डिडंट स्टार्ट exactly what is electric current. Is it clear? Yes. So in last video class we have seen the electric potential and electric potential difference, isn't it? Yes. So first of all, what is electric potential, sir? You tell me first of all, what is electric potential? Electric potential means nothing but, it's very easy one, the amount of work is done to bring a unit of either positive charge or negative charge from an infinity to a particular point. Any particular point, that is called electric potential. What is that? That is called electric potential. Then what is potential difference, sir? You may ask me, what is potential difference? Potential difference means nothing but, you consider other than infinity any point in a conductor. Okay, yes. So the amount of work is done to bring a unit of a positive charge or a negative charge from one point to another point. Note this point, from one point to another point, that is called electric potential difference, or otherwise we can say potential difference. The word potential difference, which means it has some lots of meanings, that is voltage, potential difference, potential, then EMF. These all are the same meaning for the word potential difference. Okay, so we can say potential difference or otherwise voltage, then EMF or potential, all are same meaning, you don't get confusion. Okay, so in electric potential we bring the unit of positive charge or negative charge from infinity to particular point, but in potential difference we bring the positive charge, either positive charge, unit of positive charge or negative charge from one point to another point, from one point to another point, that is called potential difference. That is called potential difference. Is it clear? Yes. Then what is the SI unit of potential difference, sir? The SI unit of potential difference is volt. What is that? The SI unit of potential difference is volt, which means the SI unit of voltage is volt, because potential difference, voltage, both are same meaning here. Okay, yes. So the potential difference, which is equal to work done divided by, what is that? Charge. Potential difference, which is equal to work done divided by charge. So the SI unit of potential difference is volt. So we can write voltage, okay, which means volt. Volt, which is equal to work done divided by charge. So what is the SI unit of work done, sir? That is obviously joule, already we know very well. Then what is the SI unit of charge, sir? Charge is, that is coulomb. So obviously we can write volt, which is equal to joule divided by coulomb. Am I right? Joule divided by coulomb. So that is equal to volt. That is equal to volt. Is it clear? So very easy. So there is one more question, like define 1 volt. Define 1 volt. So what will you write? What will you write? So already we know volt, which is equal to joule divided by coulomb. Joule divided by coulomb. Okay, yes. So what is the definition for 1 volt, sir? You may ask me. What is the definition for 1 volt? 1 volt means nothing but 1 joule of work. The 1 joule of work is act on the 1 coulomb of charge. If the charge comes to one place to another place, that is called 1 volt. That is called 1 volt. Okay, simply we say the amount of the 1 joule amount of work is act on 1 coulomb of charge. If the charge moves from one place to another place, that is called 1 volt. That is called 1 volt, which means the potential difference is 1 volt. That's all. Very easy. Okay, yes. Then the potential difference is measured by the instrument is called voltmeter. What is that? That is voltmeter. We always place these connect the voltmeter parallel to the so where the potential difference is to be calculated. Okay, for example, if you want to calculate the potential difference between across the two terminals of the conductor, we must connect the voltmeter parallel to that conductor. What is that? Parallel to that conductor, because the potential voltmeter, the voltmeter has high resistance. If we connect in series, okay, in the circuit series, the voltmeter can affect the current flows through it. That is the reason why we always connect the voltmeter in parallel to the conductor. That's a very easy one. Okay, yes. So till now we have seen up to this, which means up to this potential difference. So in this lesson we will start what is electric current. So before we starting that, what is electric current, we will see one or two sums which is based on electric potential difference. Okay, yes. So let's get started. I'll solve one or two numericals. Write down in your classwork note. Okay, please note down in your classwork note. The first problem, which is based on potential difference, how much work is done. So I'll rub that. I need some space. Look at here. How much work is done in moving a charge of 2 coulombs? How much charge? 2 coulombs charge from a point at 118 volt to 128 volts. So that is first question, which is based on potential difference. Okay, you read out how much work is done in a moving of charge of 2 coulombs. Charge value, how much? 2 coulomb charge from a point at how much? From a point at 118 volt, which means 118 volts to 128 volts. Okay, so look at here. I'll draw the diagram. Consider, this is a conductor. Okay, yes, consider the positive charge or negative charge. This is a charge. It is placed at point B. At point B, the charge has, the potential is 118 volt. How much? 118 volt. Where? At the point B, the positive charge has the potential. How much? 118 volt. Is it clear? Yes. Again, look at here. Next, we are going to bring the charge from point B to point A here. Okay, where? Point A here. So at the point B, already the charge has potential that is equal to 118 volt. So when we bring from point B to point A, that potential difference, how much? Yes, 128 volt. Where? At the point B after brought that. Is it clear? Yes. Now what is the potential difference, sir? You tell me, what is the potential difference? We always minus from high potential to low potential. Am I right? 128 is a high potential, then 118 is a low potential. So high potential minus low potential, which is equal to, what is the potential difference? That is equal to 10 volt. Potential difference equal to 10 volt. Am I right or wrong? Yes. Here, what quantity we need to calculate? We need to calculate work done. Am I right? Yes. Isn't it? It's very easy. So now what is the formula? So potential difference, look at here. potential difference which is equal to, what is the formula, sir? Yes, that is work done divided by charge. Work done divided by charge. Am I right or wrong? Yes, obviously that is right. Okay, yes. So in simple wise we can write potential difference V, work done W, and charge Q. And charge Q. Is it right or wrong? Yes. Here, what is the potential difference, sir? Potential difference 10 volt. What is that? Potential difference 10 volt. So V that is equal to 10 volt. V that is equal to 10 volt. Then charge, how much charge? How much charge has moved from 11, potential difference from 118 to 128? How much charge? 2 coulomb charge. How much? 2 coulomb charge. So Q which is equal to 2 coulomb. C which means what is that? 2 coulomb. Okay, yes. Then what quantity is left? Work done. Work done we need to calculate. We need to calculate work done. Okay, so substitute these both quantities in that formula, we can get work done. How much work is done? Okay, yes, look at here. I'll rub that. So, what is the formula? So, V which is equal to W by Q, which means potential difference V which is equal to work done divided by amount of charge moved. Okay, yes. So look at your potential difference, how much, sir? 10, sir. You apply here 10, which is equal to, then work done we need to calculate. So W is there, and divided by Q, charge, how much? 2 coulomb. Okay, otherwise we can write only 2. That's all, no problem. So when this term comes, this is what will happen. This division changes into multiplication, so we can get 10 into 2, which is equal to work done. Which is equal to work done. Am I right? Yes. So work done, what is the value here? 10 into 2 which is equal to 20. So work done which is equal to 20. What is the work done unit? Joule. So 20 joule. That's all. 20 joule. That's all. Easy. So look at here. How much work is done? 20 joule work is done to bring, note this point, to bring 2 coulomb of charge from where? From 118 potential to 128 potential. That's all. That is this question meaning. Okay, how much work is done here? 20 joule work is done to bring 2 coulomb of charge from the potential difference 118 volt to 128 volt. That's all. Khatam. Is there any doubt? No doubt. This is how we need to make numericals. Okay, yes. So this is one of the method. Then another one method I will solve here. You look at here. So second numerical, you listen here, which is based on electric potential difference. The second question, second numerical, you listen here. Calculate the work done. Calculate the work done in moving a charge of 4 coulombs. Here how much? 4 coulombs from a point at 220 volts to at a point 230 volts. How much? 230 volts. Okay, so that is a question. So what is the question? You read out here. Calculate the work done. Okay, what is that? Calculate the work done. Calculate the work done in moving a charge of 4 coulombs here. Charge value how much? 4 coulombs from at a point of 220 volts. From what point? 220 volts to at the point of 230 volts. 230 volt. Is it clear? Yes, very easy. So here, what quantity we need to calculate? We need to calculate work done. We need to calculate work done. So what are the quantities we know? Look at here. So this potential difference formula, what is that? Potential difference. Potential difference capital V, which is equal to work done. Is equal to what is that? Work done W divided by charge. The amount of charge is moved, that is Q. That is Q. Is it clear? Yes. So what are the quantities we know, sir? The charge value, how much? 4 coulomb. We know that Q, which is equal to 4 coulombs. V, that is equal to 4 coulombs. Yes. Then potential difference, how much, sir? Yes, potential difference, which means V, I'll write V in short form, capital V, which is equal to how much here? Note this point here, the charge is moved from 220 volts to 230 volt. Okay, look at here, sir. So consider conductor. This is a conductor. A test charge is placed here. Either positive charge or negative charge, no problem at all. The charge is placed here at the point B, the charge potential difference is 220 volt. How much? 220 volt. Where at the point B, that positive test charge potential difference is 220 volt. Okay, yes. Now we are going to bring the charge placed at B to A. Where? To A. To the point A. The point A is here. The point A is here. So we look at here. So we are applying some energy on the charge placed at point B, due to which we bring the charge from point B to point A. Okay. So at the point A, the potential difference of the charge is 230 volt. How much? 230 volt. Okay. Yes. Here, what is the potential difference, sir? You tell me, what is the potential difference? We always minus from high potential to low potential. Here, which is high potential, which is low potential? Yes. So this is at point A, the charge has high potential. I have written in short form HP. Then at point B, the charge has low potential. This is low potential. That is just 220 volt. Here, what is the potential difference, sir? So high potential minus low potential, which is equal to potential difference. So 230 minus 220, which is equal to 10 volt. 10 volt. The potential difference, how much? Potential difference 10 volt. So the potential difference V, that is equal to 230 volt minus 220 volt. So V, that is equal to capital V, which is equal to 10, just 10 volt. So what is the potential difference between two charges? Just 10 volt, that's all. Okay, yes. So substitute these two values in that formula, we can get the work done. How much amount of work is done? Okay, yes, I'll rub this. Look at here. So for potential difference formula, V, which is equal to W by Q. Am I right? Yes. So what is the V value, sir? 10, sir. 10, which is equal to, we need to calculate W. So let it be. Then Q, charge how much? 4 coulombs, sir. 4. So when this term comes this side, this division changes into multiplication. So we can get 10 into 4, which is equal to work done. Which is equal to work done. So 10 into 4 is equal to 40. So work done, which is equal to 40 joules. How much? 40 joules. So what is this meaning, sir? You tell me. So work done is 40 joules. What is that meaning, sir? Look at here. So when 40 joule of work is done, look at here, 40 joule of work is done to bring the charge from 220 volt to 230 volt. How much amount of work is done? 40 joule amount of work is done to bring a charge from 220 volt to 230 volt. That's all. That is a meaning for this numerical. Is it clear? It's very easy. Please try to understand my concepts, what I'm telling here. Okay, yes, that's all. So in this manner, you can get numericals in board exam. Okay, yes. So that's all. So that's all the potential, electric potential, potential different, complete. Okay, yes. You note down in your classbook note. Now I am going to start exactly what is electric current. Exactly what is electric current. See, this word potential difference has so many names. We can say voltage, EMF, potential, and so on. Okay, yes, voltage and potential, then EMF, this all word meaning same as that of the word potential difference. Potential difference. Is it clear? Yes. Okay. So now I am going to start exactly what is electric current, sir. Exactly what is electric current. Okay, yes, electric current. So now we are entering to that lesson, chapter 12, electricity. Okay, till now we have seen the fundamental concept, the all fundamental concept completed. Okay, from that fundamental concept you will get questions, one mark questions, it can be one mark questions, three mark questions, whatever it is. Okay, yes. So the main concept is electric current. Now I am going to start exactly what is electric current. Exactly what is electric current. Okay, so already we have seen the flow of electrons is called electric current. The flow of electrons is called electric current. Okay, yes, but that is not an exact meaning for this word electric current. That is not an exact meaning for that word electric current. Now I am going to start what is the exact meaning and exact formula symbol for the word electric current. Is that clear? Yes. So already we know. Okay, so before starting that, what is electric current? You must know some important terms. Some important terms. Is it clear? Yes. See, already we know what is electric potential and potential difference. Is it clear? Yes. What is electric potential, sir? The amount of work is done to bring a unit of either positive charge or negative charge from an infinity to particular point. That is electric potential. Am I right? Yes. Then already we know what is potential difference. What is potential difference, sir? Potential difference means nothing but the amount of work is done to bring, know this point, to bring a unit of either positive charge or negative charge from one point to another point. From one point to another point, that is called electric potential difference. Okay, or otherwise we can say potential difference. Am I right? Yes. What makes this potential difference? Very big questions rising here. What makes this potential difference? What makes this potential difference? Can you bring the charge from one point to another point by your hand? No, we cannot do that. Okay, we cannot do that. Then what makes the potential difference? That is very big question. What makes this potential difference? This potential difference, know this point. This potential difference may produced by a cell or battery or any other power generators. Okay, note this point. A potential difference may produced by a cell or battery or any other power generators. Okay, so what makes this potential difference? The potential difference caused by it may be a cell, a battery, or any other power generator. Okay, now consider a cell. Already we know cell is made up of chemical substances. Am I right? Cell is made up of chemical substances. So chemical substances in it. So chemical reaction happens inside it. am I right or wrong? Yes. Chemical reaction happens inside it. Due to chemical reaction, note this point, very important. Due to this chemical reaction, the cell generates potential difference. The cell generates potential difference. It's not only for cell, this is for even battery as well as any other power generators. Okay, so due to the chemical reaction, for example, only cell, in cell, due to the chemical reaction, it creates, which means it generates potential difference across its two terminals. Okay, note this point. Already we know the cell has a single cell. A cell has two terminals. Am I right? A cell has two terminals. This is positive terminal, this is negative terminal. Am I right? Yes, this is cell. The cell symbol. A cell has two terminals, first one positive terminal and second one that is negative terminal. This positive terminal generates high potential. High potential, note this point, very important. The positive terminal of a cell generates high potential, whereas this negative terminal of a cell generates low potential. What is that? Low potential. Is it clear? Yes. So this is a cell structure. The positive terminal, cell has two terminals, positive terminal, second one is a negative terminal. This positive terminal of a cell generates high potential, whereas this negative terminal of a cell generates low potential. What is that? Low potential. Is it clear? See, actually the potential difference is a kind of pressure. Note this point, the potential difference is a kind of pressure. Okay, which means we can say the pressure between the electric charges. What is that? The pressure between the electric charges. Okay, note this point, potential difference is a kind of pressure. Okay, or otherwise we can say the pressure between the electric charge, this potential difference is produced by a cell or battery or any other power generator. Note this point. Okay, yes, the cell, a single cell has a two terminals. The first one is a positive terminal, second one is a negative terminal. The positive terminal of a cell generates high potential, which means high pressure. Then the negative terminal of the cell generates, what is that? Low potential, which means that is low pressure. Note this point. So this high potential and low potential, which means the high pressure and low pressure of a cell, what is that? Electrons to move, electrons to flow inside the conductor. Okay, very, very important. No, don't get confusion. So look at here. So when we connect, when a cell is connected to a conducting circuit, this high potential and low potential makes the electrons flow. That electrons flow is called current. Okay, to flow electrons, note this point, to flow electrons from one point to another point, there must be potential difference, which means there must be pressure difference, okay, among the charged particles. Otherwise electrons will not flow. Okay, here what causes this pressure, which means potential difference? It can be a cell, a battery, or any other power generator. Okay, note this point. To electrons flow from one point to another point, they need some potential difference, which means they need some pressure. That pressure is produced by a cell, battery, or any other power generator. Okay, yes, let us consider the analogy of water flow. Okay, look at here. So let us consider the analogy of water flow. Consider two beaker. Imagine you have two beakers. Okay, look at here. Imagine you have two beakers. So this is beaker one. And this is beaker two. Imagine you have two beakers, beaker one and beaker two, placed at equal height. Note this point, placed at equal height. The two beakers are placed at equal height. Is it clear? Yes. Then the two beakers filled with equal amount of water. The two beakers filled with equal amount of water. Note this point. Yes, likewise, here also it is filled with equal amount of water. So both beakers water level is same. Water level is same. Okay, listen here. Imagine you have two beakers placed at equal height. Equal height, and two beakers are filled with equal amount of water. Equal amount of water. So look at here. So this level and this level water. So water is same. Okay, two beakers are filled with equal amount of water. Is it clear? Yes. Next, look at here. They are both connected. Note this point. They are both connected by a pipe at bottom. Note this point. They are both, look at here, this is a pipe. They are both connected by a pipe at the bottom. At the bottom. Is it clear? Which means two beakers are connected by a pipe at the bottom of the beakers. Is it clear? Yes. If you observe the two beakers for a few seconds, do you think the water level will decrease? The water will flow from one beaker to another beaker? Okay, look at here. If you know this point, if you observe these two beakers for a few seconds, do you think the water will flow from one beaker to another? No. Water will not flow from one beaker to another. Note this point. Here, water will not flow from one beaker to another beaker. Either one beaker, first beaker to another beaker, or second beaker to first beaker. Water will not flow here. Is it clear? Yes. Why, sir? Why? Because here the two beakers are placed at equal height, as well as the two beakers filled with equal amount of water. So the water amount also same, as well as the two beakers are placed equal height, same height. So in this situation, water will not flow from one beaker to another. One beaker to another. Is it clear? Now this point, first you consider the two beakers, and two beakers are placed at equal height. Equal height. Okay, yes. Then the two beakers, they are filled with equal amount of water. Equal amount of water. Then they are both connected by a pipe at the bottom of the beakers each other. Is it clear? Yes. If you observe this setup, which means two beakers for a few seconds, do you think water will flow from one beaker to another? No, here water will not flow from one beaker to another. Why? Because here the two beakers water level is same, and the two beakers are placed at equal height, due to which there is no flow of water. There is no flow of water. Am I right? Yes. Next, I'm going to give you a task. Okay, so let me give you a task. Look at here. Here, how do you make, at this point, how do you make the water flow from beaker 2 to beaker 1? Okay, I'm going to giving you a task. Okay, I'm going to give you a task. Okay, here you need to make the flow of water from beaker 2 to beaker 1. But you are not allowed to change the water level, amount of water level from one of the beaker to another. okay, but you need to make the flow of water. How it is possible, tell me. Okay, understand my question again, it's very easy one. Here two beakers, here in this situation water will not flow. But I'm going to giving you a task. So what is the task, sir? The task is you need to make water flow from beaker 2 to beaker 1. But you are not allowed to change the amount of water in any of the beaker. Without changing the amount of water in any of the beaker, you need to make a water flow from beaker 2 to beaker 1. Can you do that? Can you make it easy? You tell me. Which means you cannot add or remove the amount of water from any one of the beaker. Okay, so without changing the amount of water, note this point, without changing the amount of the water in any of the beaker, you need to make a water flow from beaker 2 to beaker 1. Can you do that? How will you do that? We can do that. Once the height of the beaker 2 is increased, the water automatically will flow from beaker 2 to beaker 1. Am I right or wrong? First case, both beakers are placed at equal distance, which means equal height. Once the beaker 2 height is raised up due to gravity, automatically the water will flow from beaker 2 to beaker 1. Am I right or wrong? Yes, obviously, right? I'll draw the diagram. You look at here. So this is beaker 1. So when we raise the height of the beaker 2, the water will flow from beaker 2 to beaker 1. This is a pipe. Okay, yes, this is a pipe. Then in beaker 2 water level decreases, whereas in beaker 1 water level increases, because water flows from beaker 2 to beaker 1. Okay, yes. Okay, look at here. When we raised, so this height, this much amount of height that beaker 2 increased, is a height raised. Okay, look at here. When we increase the height of the beaker 2 from where it is kept, so automatically due to gravity, from beaker water will flow from beaker 2 to beaker 1. Am I right? Beaker 2 to beaker 1. So through this pipe. Is it clear? Yes. So due to which in beaker 1 water level increases, in beaker 2 water level decreases. Why it happens like that? Actually, so what is happening there? You tell me. What is happening there? So when the two beakers are placed at equal height, there is no flow of water. Am I right? There is no flow of water from one beaker to another. Isn't it? Yes. So when the beaker 2 height is raised up, what happening there? Here, high water pressure generates there. Okay, water pressure high when the beaker 2 is raised. Okay, here the water pressure is more. Am I right or wrong? Yes. So when the beaker 2 is raised up, high pressure creates there. So the water flows from high pressure to low pressure. So at the beaker 1, low pressure is creates. Okay, already there is low pressure. When the beaker 2 raised up, high pressure is generated there. Due to high pressure, water flows from beaker 2 to beaker 1. Here water flows from high pressure to low pressure. What is that? High pressure to low pressure. okay. In first case, when the two beakers are placed at equal height, there is no flow of water from any one of the beaker. When the beaker 2 is raised up, water starts flowing from beaker 2 to beaker 1. Why? Because when the height is raised, know this point, when the beaker 2 height is raised, high pressure generates there. Where? At the beaker 2, high pressure generates there. Still the beaker 1 is in same place. Where? Same place where we kept in first case. At same place. So here, due to this raised height, the beaker 2 has high pressure and the beaker 1 has low pressure. So automatically the water flows from high pressure to low pressure. What is that? High pressure to low pressure. Is it clear? Yes. In the similar way, electrons also flows from high potential to low potential. High potential to low potential. Note this point, very important. Okay, very, very important point here. So here the water flows from high pressure to low pressure. Is it clear? In similar way, electric charges also flows from high potential to low potential. Here, who makes this potential difference? It may be a cell, a battery, or any other power generator. Okay, here, note this point. To make the water flow from one beaker to another beaker, there must be pressure difference. Am I right? There must be pressure difference. Likewise, to move the charge from one point to another point, there must be pressure. That pressure is potential difference. That potential difference is produced by, it may be a cell, battery, or any other power generator. Is it clear? Yes. Okay, so this is an analogy of water flow. So to make a water flow from one of the beaker to another one, there must be pressure difference. So the beaker 1 has high pressure and beaker 2 has low pressure, due to which water flows from beaker 2 to beaker 1. Likewise, electric charges also need some pressure to flow from one point to another point. That pressure is produced by a cell. It may be a cell, battery, or whatever it is. Isn't it? Yes. Next, we will see what is electric current exactly. Okay. Yes. Look at here. So already we know copper is one of the good conductor of electricity. Copper is one of the very good conductor of electricity, isn't it? Yes. See, copper has so many free electrons. The copper metal has so many free electrons. So before applying the potential difference across its two terminals, the free electrons are moving randomly here and there. Okay, look at here, the free electrons are moving randomly here and there. Okay, look at here, I'll draw the diagram. Consider a copper wire. It's a copper wire, but it's a very big sized copper wire. Okay, yes. Consider the copper wire. Copper is one of the very good conductor of electricity. This copper wire having lots of free electrons, yes, like this. So many free electrons will be there, billions and billions of free electrons will be there. Okay, not 1 or 200,000, like that, millions and billions of free electrons will be there. Okay, yes, look at here. Consider, it is one of a conductor, copper wire. copper wire. The copper wire having lots of free electron. Before applying the potential difference, note this point, before connecting with the battery or cell, the free electrons are moving randomly here and there. The electrons are moving here and there randomly. Is it clear? Yes. When we connect the copper wire, look at here. When we connect the copper wire along with the potential difference, what is this? This is a potential difference. Potential difference produced by what? It may be cell, battery, or any other power generator. Am I right? So consider this is battery. Battery, what will happen? Already we know this positive terminal of the battery creates high potential, whereas the negative terminal of the battery creates low potential. Am I right? Yes. So along with this conducting wire, high potential creates at this end. Am I right? Yes. Here high potential. So along with this negative terminal and this conducting wire, low potential creates here at the two terminals of the conductor. So conductor is the first terminal, and maybe first terminal, second terminal, what is it? Conductor is one of the terminal, and this is another one of the terminal. So when we connect the, notice point. So when we connect these conductors along with the battery, okay, what is that? Battery, the battery produces potential difference. Okay, yes. The positive terminal produces high potential, which means high pressure. Okay, in other words, high pressure. And this negative terminal produces low potential, which means less pressure. Is that clear? Very easy. Okay, yes. So high potential, which means high pressure generates through this positive terminal, so through this conductor. Then low potential creates along with this negative terminal through this conductor. Due to this potential difference, note this point. Due to this potential difference, which means high potential and low potential, the electron starts moving in a particular direction. That flow of electron is called electricity. Is it clear? Look at here. The high potential is here and low potential is there. Okay, high potential generates along with the positive terminal of the cell, and low potential generates along with the negative terminal of the cell or battery, whatever it is. Okay, due to this potential difference, note this point. Due to this potential difference, along with the two terminals of the conductor, the electrons starts moving in a particular direction, only one direction. The flow of electrons is called current. Is it clear? Actually, the potential difference, which means the battery or cell, which aligns the all electrons to flow in a particular direction. But before connecting with this battery, electrons are moving randomly here and there, isn't it? Yes. So when the conductors connected with the battery or cells, whatever it is, it creates potential difference. Due to this potential difference, all free electrons starts moving towards a particular direction, towards only one direction. This flow of electron is called, what is that? Current. Here, what makes the all electrons flow in a particular direction? That is battery. The battery produces a potential difference. This battery produces a potential difference. Okay, actually, so what is the work of this potential difference? Which means battery. What is that work? The battery which aligns the all electrons to flow in a particular direction, only one direction by potential difference. know this point by potential difference. Is it clear? Yes, very easy one. Okay, yes. Now consider this. So what is the definition for current, sir? What is the definition for current? Okay, already we know flow of electrons is called current. What is the exact definition, sir? Look at here. It is a conductor. So it's a copper wire. It is a conductor, is a one of the conductor copper wire. Consider any area. Consider any area in copper wire. Consider any area of cross section or any area, particular area in the conductor. Okay. So when, note this point. So when the battery is connected with the two terminals of the conductor, how much electrons, note this point, how much electrons flowing per second? Per second, how many electric charges flow through a particular area of cross section of a conductor? That is called electric current. That is called electric current. So the amount of charges flows through a particular area of a conductor in unit time means per second, that is called current. That is called current. Okay, I'll write the definition. You look at here, or I'll write here. The amount of electric charges. What is electric charge? Electric charge means nothing but electron. Electric charge flows through a particular area of cross section, area of cross section of a conductor, of a conductor in unit time. In unit time is called electric current. Very important definition. Okay, look at here. It is a definition for the word electric current. The amount of electric charge, not this point, the amount of electric charge, which means what is that? Electrons here, electrons only flowing here. So the amount of electric charge flows through a particular area of cross section of a conductor in unit time, which means nothing but per second. So per second, note this point, per second, how much amount of electric charges flows through a particular area of cross section of a conductor, that is called current. It may be 1 coulomb, 2 coulomb, 3 coulomb, 100 coulomb, so whatever it is, how much amount of electric charges flows through a particular area of cross section of a conductor in per second, okay, which means in unit time, that is called electric current. That is called, what is that? Electric current. Okay, you can take so any area of cross section. It can be this one or this one, so whatever it is, per second, how much amount of electrons flowing through a particular area of cross section in a conductor, that is called electric current. Or otherwise we can say the rate of flow of charges. What is that? The rate of flow of electric charge is called electric current. So all are same meaning here. Okay, look at here. What is that? The rate of flow of electric charge in physics, note this point, in physics the word rate, which means per second, how much amount of electric charges flowing, that is called current. Is it clear? It's a very easy one. Here, what makes, note this point, is a very, very important term. Here, what makes the flow of electrons in a particular direction? What makes potential difference makes the electrons to flow in a particular direction? Okay, here the potential difference produced by, it may be a cell, a battery, or any other power generator. Is it clear? It's a very easy one. So what is the conclusion, sir, here? What is the conclusion? Okay, look at here. Before we connect this conductor along with this battery or cell or any other power supply, the electrons, free electrons are moving randomly here and there. They don't have a particular direction to flow, isn't it? Yes. When we connect the conductor, two terminals of the conductors along with this battery, what happens? The battery sits, which means the battery aligns the all electrons to flow in a particular direction, only one direction. Why? Because this battery produces the potential difference. The positive terminal of the battery produces high potential, which means high pressure between the electric charges. Then the negative terminal produces the low potential, which means low pressure among the charged particles, okay, among the electric charge, isn't it? Yes. Due to this high potential and low potential, the electron starts flowing in a particular direction. This flow of electrons, note this point, the all free electrons flowing, which makes electric energy. That electric energy is called electric current. Is it clear? Yes, that's all. So what is the function of this battery? The battery only align, okay, which means sets the all electron to flow in a particular direction. Is that clear? Yes, that's all. Okay, then what is the exact definition, sir? Exact definition means nothing but the amount of electric charge flows through a particular area of cross section of a conductor unit time. Okay, you consider, so it is a conductor, you can say any area of the cross section of the conductor. So this is the area of the cross section of a conductor. Per second, note this point, per second, how much electric charges flows through this particular area of cross section of a conductor, that is called current. Okay, per second, note this point, per second, how much amount of electric charges flowing through the particular area of cross section of a conductor, that is called electric current. Okay, here the amount of charge may be 2 coulomb, 3 coulomb, 5 coulombs, whatever it is, that is depend on the potential difference, that is no matter. Okay, is it clear? Yes. Here, what is the exact meaning for electric current? The amount of electric charge flows through a particular area of a conductor in unit time. Unit time means nothing but, in physics, unit time means per second, how much amount of electrons flowing in a particular area of the cross section of a conductor, that is called current. Or otherwise we can say the other definition for the current, the rate of flow of electric charge is called current. In physics, the word rate, which means per second, how much amount of electrons flowing, that is called current. That's all. Okay, that's all. Shall I explain in Tamil? Because it's a very important concept. Okay, yes. So nama next current na enna nu paakaporam. Okay, yes. Nama lower class padichirpom current na enna nu. The flow of electrons is called current nu padichirpom. Okay, va. So in electrons flow agudhu. Edhanaala electrons flow agudhu? Nama poi thalli vidroma. Who is pushing here? Who is pushing the electrons? You or myself, no? நானும் பண்ண முடியாது, நீயும் பண்ண முடியாது. ஓகேவா? எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் யாருங்க புஷ் பண்ணுறது? எலக்ட்ரான்ஸை ஒரு டைரக்ஷனில் அலைன் பண்ணுறது யார் அப்படின்னா, எந்த டிவைஸ் என்ன அப்படின்னா, இந்த பேட்டரி. இது பேட்டரியாக இருக்கலாம், செல்லாக இருக்கலாம், வேறு ஏதாவது ஒரு பவர் ஜென்ரேட்டராக இருக்கலாம். ஓகேவா? எஸ். ஒரு கண்டக்டராக கன்சிடர் பண்ணி, ஒரு காப்பர் ஒயரை கன்சிடர் பண்ணி, இது ஒரு காப்பர் ஒயர். இந்த காப்பர் ஒயருக்குள்ள நிறைய ஃப்ரீ எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் இருக்கும். இந்த ஃப்ரீ எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் என்ன பண்ணும், இந்த பேட்டரியோட கனெக்ட் பண்ணுறதுக்கு முன்னாடி ஃப்ரீ எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் மூவ் ஆகிட்டே இருக்கும், அங்கேயும் இங்கேயும் ரேண்டமாக மூவ் ஆகிட்டு இருக்கும். இந்த டைரக்ஷன் அந்த டைரக்ஷன் அங்கேயும் ஒரு ரேண்டமாக மூவ் ஆகிட்டு இருக்கும். ஓகேவா? பட் நமக்கு என்ன, நமக்கு கரண்ட் என்ன தெரியும், நமக்கு எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் என்ன பண்ணணும், ஒரே ஒரு டைரக்ஷனில் மூவ் ஆகணும். இந்த எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ்லாம் ஒரே ஒரு டைரக்ஷனில் யார் மூவ் பண்ணுவோம் அப்படின்னா, இந்த செல் இல்லை பேட்டரி தான் என்ன பண்ணும், அலைன் பண்ணும். ஸோ இந்த கண்டக்டரை நம்ம என்ன பண்ணுறோம், கண்டக்டரை ஒரு பேட்டரியோ இல்லை செல்லோடய கனெக்ட் பண்ணும்போது என்ன அப்படின்னா, ஸோ ஆல்ரெடி நமக்கு தெரியும் பாசிட்டிவ் டெர்மினலில் என்ன இருக்கும், ஹை ப்ரெஷர் இருக்கும், விச் மீன்ஸ் ஹை பொட்டன்ஷியல் இருக்கும். ஆமாவா? எஸ். நெகட்டிவ் டெர்மினலில் லோ பொட்டன்ஷியல் இருக்கும். ஓகேவா? இந்த ஹை பொட்டன்ஷியலும் லோ பொட்டன்ஷியலும் சேர்ந்து என்ன பண்ணும் அப்படின்னா, எலக்ட்ரான்ஸை நீ இந்த டைரக்ஷனில் மட்டும் ஃபோ அப்படின்னு சொல்லி அலைன் பண்ணும். ஓகேவா? இந்த ஹை ப்ரெஷரும் லோ ப்ரெஷரும் வச்சு ஹை பொட்டன்ஷியல் சொல்லணும். நம்ம ஹை பொட்டன்ஷியலும் லோ பொட்டன்ஷியலும் என்ன பண்ணுவோம், எலக்ட்ரான்ஸை நீ இந்த டைரக்ஷன்லேயே போ அப்படின்னு சொல்லி ஒரு டைரக்ஷன் அலைன் பண்ணும். இந்த எலக்ட்ரான்ஸுடைய ஃப்ளோ தான் நம்ம சொல்கிறோம் கரண்ட்டுன்னு சொல்கிறோம். எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் ஒரு ஃப்ளோ என்ன சொல்றோம் நம்ம கரண்ட்னு சொல்றோம் ஓகேவா எஸ் ஸோ இதை கண்டக்டர் வச்சுக்கோ இந்த கண்டக்டரோட இது வந்து ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் ஏரியாவை சூஸ் பண்ணிக்கோ கண்டக்டர் இந்த காப்பர் ஒயர் இந்த காப்பர் ஒயர் ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் ஏரியாவை சூஸ் பண்ணிக்கோ இந்த பர்டிகுலர் ஏரியாவில் ஒரு செகண்டுக்கு எவ்வளோ சார்ஜ் கிராஸ் ஆகுது எவ்வளோ சார்ஜ் ஃப்ளோ ஆகுது அதுதான் எக்ஸாக்ட் மீனிங் ஃபார் தி வேர்ட் எலக்ட்ரிக் கரண்ட் எக்ஸாக்ட் மீனிங் ஃபார் தி வேர்ட் எலக்ட்ரிக் கரண்ட் ஒரு செகண்டுக்கு எவ்வளோ சார்ஜ் போகுது ஒரு கூலுமாக இருக்கலாம் ரெண்டு கூலுமாக இருக்கலாம் 10 கூலுமாக இருக்கலாம் எது வேணுமாலும் இருக்கலாம் ஒரு செகண்டுக்கு ஒரு பர்டிகுலர் ஏரியா ஆஃப் கிராஸ் செக்ஷன் ஆஃப் அ கண்டக்டரில் எவ்வளோ எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் ஃப்ளோ ஆகுது ஒரு செகண்டுக்கு எவ்வளோ எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் ஃப்ளோ ஆகுது தட் இஸ் கால்டு கரண்ட் தட் இஸ் கால் கரண்ட் தட்ஸ் ஆல் ஸோ இங்கே பேட்டரியோடைய ஒர்க் என்ன இங்கே பேட்டரியோட ஒர்க் என்ன அப்படின்னா அந்த எலக்ட்ரான்ஸ் எல்லாம் நீ ஒரே டைரக்ஷனில் போகணும்னு சொல்லி அலைன் பண்ணுது இந்த பேட்டரி என்ன பண்ணுது எல்லா எலக்ட்ரான்ஸும் இந்த டேரக்ஷனில் மட்டும்தான் போகணும்னு சொல்லிட்டு என்ன பண்ணுது அலைன் பண்ணுது எதனால் அலைன் பண்ணுது இந்த பொட்டன்ஷியல் டிஃப்ரென்ஸ்னால அலைன் பண்ணுது ஓகேவா தட்ஸ் ஆர் இதுதான் எலக்ட்ரிக் கரண்ட் எதுவுமே கிடையாது ரொம்ப சிம்பிள் தான் ஓகேவா தட்ஸ் ஆர் ஸோ தட்ஸ் ஆல் அபவுட் தி எலக்ட்ரிக் கரண்ட் ஓகே தட்ஸ் ஈஸி ஓகே லுக் அட் ஹியர் So this electric current is denoted by the letter capital I. Current, note this point, current, electric current is denoted by the letter capital I. What is that? Capital I, isn't it? Yes. So look at here. So current which is equal to, note this point, current which is equal to the amount of charge flowing per second. Amount of charge flowing per second. Am I right? Yes. So which is equal to charge divided by time. Charge divided by time. Okay. So electric current which is equal to amount of charge. Note this point. Amount of electric charge flowing per second. That is called current. Already we know very well. So we can write current which is equal to charge divided by time. What is that? Charge divided by time. Isn't it? Yes. See, current already we know current is denoted by letter capital I. So, I which is equal to charge denoted by letter capital Q and time divided by T. So, this is the current formula. I equal to Q by T. What is that? I which is equal to Q by T. This is a current formula. You keep this formula in your mind always. Because till up to end of this lesson, we will use this formula. Current which is equal to Q by T. Okay? Yes, look at here. What is current? So already we know. The amount of electric charges flows through a particular area of cross section of a conductor in unit time. That is called current. So current which is equal to how much amount of electric charges flowing through a particular area of cross section of conductor per second, which means in unit time, that is called current. So we can write current which is equal to charge divided by time. Am I right? Charge divided by time. So how much amount of charges flowing per unit time, that is current current formula. So current is equal to charge divided by T. So the word the current denoted by letter I, capital I. Capital I which is equal to charge denoted by letter capital Q already we know and time small t so current I so Q sorry I which is equal to Q by T the current formula what is that I which is equal to Q by T okay yes that's all so please try to understand my concept it's very easy you don't get complication So next one, so what is the SI unit of current, sir? What is the SI unit of current? You tell me. You know that? Yes, I know that. The SI unit of current is SI unit of current is ampere. What is that? SI unit of current is that is ampere. This word ampere is named after the French scientist Henri Marie Ampere. Okay, who's that? Henri Marie Ampere. Henri Marie Ampere. Because who found that current? okay, the current unit, current, how much amount of current flowing particular area of cross section. Okay, so after named the Andy Mary Ampere, the current SI unit is discovered like ampere. Ampere is denoted by letter capital A. What is that? Capital A. Okay, so during the year of 1775 to 1836. Whose year? Whose living year? The scientist, the French scientist Andy Mary Ampere. Okay, yes. So what is the conclusion, sir? The SI unit of current is ampere. What is that? SI unit of current is ampere. Ampere is denoted by the letter capital A. Capital A. Is it clear? Yes. Look at here. So already we know what is current, sir? What is current? Current I, which is equal to Q by T. Look at here. Current I, which is equal to Q by T. Am I right? This is a current formula, which means the amount of electric charges flowing through a particular area of cross section of a conductor in unit time. In unit time, that is called current. So I equal to Q by T. Am I right? Yes. Next question rises here. Sir, if SI unit of electric current is ampere, what is 1 ampere, sir? You may ask me. What is 1 ampere? So next question rising here, define 1 ampere, which means 1 ampere. Define 1 ampere, sir. That is next question. What is that? Define 1 ampere, isn't it? Yes, look at here. I equal to Q by T. What is I, sir? Here, what is I? I, which means current. So SI unit of current is ampere. So you put here ampere, which is equal to Q. Q means what is that? Electric charge. Q means electric charge. What is the SI unit of electric charge? That is coulomb. Ampere, which is equal to coulomb. Am I right? Yes. Which is equal to coulomb divided by time. What is the SI unit of time? That is seconds. Isn't it? Yes, look at here. I equal to Q by T, that is a current formula. I, which means current, Q, charge, T, time. Current SI unit, ampere, then Q SI unit, which means electric charge SI unit, coulomb, then time SI unit, seconds. Time SI unit, second, isn't it? Look at here. So there will be 1, 1, 1. You just consider, no problem at all. You just consider there is 1 in front of the all quantities. 1, 1, 1. Okay, yes. So next question rises here. So define 1 ampere. So 1 ampere, which is equal to 1 coulomb divided by 1 second. 1 coulomb divided by 1 second. Okay, so note down this formula in your classwork note. It's very important one. The very important 3 more question. Define 1 volt. So 1 ampere, which is equal to 1 coulomb divided by 1 second. So what is the meaning, sir? What is the explanation, sir? You tell me. What is the explanation? So, when one coulomb of charge flowing through a particular area of cross section in 1 second, then the current is said to be 1 ampere. Then the current value is said to be 1 ampere. Note this point. So when 1 coulomb of charge flowing through a particular area of cross section of a conductor in 1 second, then the current value is said to be 1 ampere. 1 ampere. Isn't it? Yes. Look at here. I'll start with the example. You listen. Consider the conductor. It's a copper wire. It may be copper wire. So whatever it is, no problem at all. Copper is one of the good conductor. Good conductor, yes. Okay, yes. So this electrons, so many free electrons are there. In copper, so many free electrons are there. Okay, so this is the one end of the copper wire, this is another end of the copper wire. Connect the two end of the copper wire along with the battery or any other power supply. Plus minus. Okay, okay students, listen here. So consider the conductor, copper wire. So many free electrons are there. Connect the two end of the copper wires along with the power supply. Along with the power supply, the positive terminal, negative terminal, isn't it? Yes. So due to this potential difference, what will happen? The electrons starts flowing. Electrons starts flowing through this conductor. Through this conductor, because potential difference is here. This is a low, this is a high potential, and this is a low potential. So electron starts moving, electron starts flowing inside the conductor, isn't it? Yes. Now we consider. So what is 1 ampere, sir? 1 ampere is a current. Current is 1 ampere is a quantity of current. So 1 ampere, which is equal to 1 coulomb divided by 1 second. So when 1 coulomb of electric charges flowing through a particular area of a cross section of a conductor in 1 second, that current value is said to be 1 ampere. That current will be said to be 1 ampere. Okay, yes, consider. Look at here. So, consider any particular area of cross section of a conductor like this. I have considered this area. I have considered this area of the cross section of the conductor. Area of the cross section of the conductor. For this point. Look at here. So, through this area of the cross section of the conductor. Okay, look at here. Through this area. Through this area, if 1 coulomb of charge, what is that? 1 coulomb of electric charge. 1 coulomb is equal to how much? 6.25 × 10⁻¹⁸ electrons. Am I right? If 1 coulomb of electron flows through this area of cross section in one second, then the current value is said to be 1 ampere. Then the current value is said to be, what is that? 1 ampere. Is it clear? It's a very easy one. Don't panic. Very easy. 1 ampere is equal to, how is that? 1 coulomb divided by 1 second. It is a conductor. It is a conductor. You can say any area of cross section in conductor. So I have considered this area. This area cross section of the conductor. Okay. So through this area, note this point. Through this area, if 1 coulomb of electric charge flows in one second, then the current value is said to be 1 ampere. Then the current value is said to be 1 ampere. That's all, very easy one. So when 1 coulomb of electric charges flowing through a particular area of cross section of conductor in 1 second, then the current is said to be 1 ampere. That current value is 1 ampere. That's all, very easy one. Okay students, yes. So this is 1 ampere. Okay, yes. As I explain Tamil, yes. So next paakkanum 1 ampere nu paakkanum enna paakkanum 1 ampere nu paakkanum 1 ampere na 1 ampere is equal to 1 coulomb divided by 1 second. Okay, or conductor eduthuko, idu conductor, copper wire. Copper wire la edha or area eduthuko, particular area of cross section eduthuko. Na endha area of cross section la 1 second la 1 coulomb electric charge flow aachina, then the particular area of cross section la 1 second la 1 coulomb electrons pochu appadina, that is called 1 ampere. That is called 1 ampere current. Okay, that is called 1 ampere current. So in one second, if 1 coulomb electrons flowing through any particular area of a cross section of a conductor is called 1 ampere. That is called 1 ampere. Okay, 1 second la 1 coulomb charge pochina, flow aachina or particular area of cross section la, that is called 1 ampere. That is called 1 ampere. That's all, very easy one. Okay students, yes, katam, is there any doubt? Yes. So obviously it's 1 ampere, which is equal to 1 coulomb divided by 1 second. So when 1 coulomb of charge flows through a particular area of cross section of a conductor in one second, then the current value is said to be 1 ampere. 1 ampere, use that, sir. Here, what makes this electrons flow? The potential difference makes the electrons flow in a particular direction. Okay, yes, katam, very easy. Okay, yes. Okay students, next we will see the unit. See, these all are very important one. Please note down your classwork note. See, actually, this ampere is a biggest unit. Ampere, already you know, ampere is a current unit. The ampere is a biggest unit. Biggest unit. We need some smallest unit. Okay, see, ampere. 1 ampere is not possible for all the time. Okay, 1 ampere is not possible for all the time. Okay, we need some smallest unit. The smallest unit is, one of the smallest unit is milliampere. What is that? Milliampere. Okay, then another one is microampere. Another one is microampere. Okay, so milliampere mean nothing but denoted by the letter m, a, small m, a, small m for milli, then a for ampere, then micro, so microampere. So this symbol is for micro and a for ampere. Okay, look at here. Ampere is a biggest unit. Ampere means what is that? A, capital A, current unit. Ampere is a biggest unit. So we need some smallest unit for our alternation. So one of the smallest unit is milliampere. Milliampere denoted by the letter small m, a. M small a for milli, then a for ampere. Then another one smallest unit is microampere. So this symbol is micro, then a for ampere. So 1 milliampere, 1 milliampere, which is equal to 1/1000 ampere, 1/1000 ampere, 1 milliampere, which is equal to 1/1000 ampere, or otherwise we can write 10^-3 ampere, 10^-3 ampere, isn't it? Yes. But microampere, which is equal to 10^-6 ampere, 10^-6 ampere. Okay, sometimes, however, sometimes the both units also used, the microampere, milliampere also used. Is it clear? Because SI unit, current SI unit ampere, if that quantity has given in milliampere or microampere, we need to change into, what is that? Ampere. Isn't it? Yes. So is a small, both are smallest unit. Milliampere, 1 milliampere, which is equal to 1/1000 ampere, or otherwise we can write 10^-3 ampere. Then 1 microampere, which is equal to 10^-6 ampere. Okay, that is based on numerical. Okay, we will use later when we solving the numericals. Isn't it? Yes, that's a very easy one. Okay, yes. Next one. So next one's instrument. Sir, how can we calculate the current, sir? How can we calculate the current value, sir? Okay, see, we can calculate the potential difference by an instrument is called voltmeter. Likewise, here also we need some instrument to calculate the current, how much amount of current is flowing through the electric circuit. That instrument is called ammeter. That instrument is called ammeter. So ammeter is a device which is used to measure the quantity of the current. So it's an ammeter. Ammeter is an instrument which is used to measure the quantity of the current, how much amount of current is flowing through the circuit, like that. Okay, the device name is, what is that? Ammeter. Ammeter symbol I'll draw here. Look at here. It's an ammeter symbol. So plus, it's a minus. This terminal is positive terminal and that terminal is a negative terminal. This is an ammeter schematic diagram. Okay, yes. This ammeter, notice point. This ammeter is always connected in parallel to the conductor, or where the potential, where the current, sorry, not a parallel, sir, series, sorry, I thought that is a voltmeter, you don't get confusion. So this ammeter is always connected in series in the circuit. Okay, look at here. So ammeter, positive, negative. Okay, it's not in parallel, don't get confusion, in series. It's a conductor. Plus minus. Yes, this is connected with battery or cell, plus minus, a key is here. It's a key. Okay, yes. This ammeter, note this point. This ammeter is always connected in series along with this circuit, along with this conductor, any other device. There will be any other device. There will be a bulb, fan, refrigerator, so whatever it is. So this ammeter is always connected in series along with this electric circuit. Okay, so look at here, it is connected in series. But the voltmeter is always connected in parallel to the circuit, parallel to the where the potential difference to be calculated. But the ammeter is always connected in series. Why, sir? Why? Because this ammeter has less resistance instrument, which means low resistance. It has low resistance, due to which this ammeter is always connected in series along with the circuit. So it has low resistance, so the ammeter never affect the current flows through the circuit. Okay, so if the current flows a 6 ampere, this ammeter does not affect the any amount of current flowing through it. Okay, because it has low resistance, and the circuit and the entire circuit the current value will be 6 ampere. Okay, through along with this entire circuit, the current value will be 6 ampere. This ammeter never affect the current, the amount of current flowing through the circuit, isn't it? Because the ammeter has low resistance material. That is the reason why it's always connected in series along with the circuit. Is it clear? Yes. That's all, students. Very easy one. Please try to understand the concept. Don't get memorize anything. Okay. This class getting over. I hope this class will be very useful for you. note down these all things in your classwork note. The classwork things are very important one. Okay, yes. So this class getting over. Remaining we will see next class. Okay, thank you, students.